Today I'm starting off with Sucrum's Brewing Company's Moon Tower Stout. Malty, roasty, dark chocolate. Moon Tower is an American stout with heavy malt flavors. This stout has roasted coffee-like aromas with hints of rich dark chocolate in the taste. I like that. I hope I can encourage them to keep this stout of theirs on the shelf. So, I don't have the mail out here yet. I thought I've had a few questions about my video making process, so I figured I'd do a little bit behind the scenes while I'm doing this. So as the mail comes in, long-term viewers will know this. I put it into my mail buffer here instead of first in, first out. So way back there is the most recent stuff that's arrived, and here is the stuff that's been chilling for a while, and that's what we're going to look at today. As they come in, I blank out the address and make note of when it came in. So these ones are June, July, August. Yeah, that's the time frame that these arrived. So obviously they will have been ordered weeks or months before that. So there's the most recent one to arrive. Then I just peel these stickers and I put them up here right in front of my forehead so that I can refer to it while I'm talking. And then as I look stuff up on the computer, I will just add a note to those so that I can refer to it at the end when I'm doing the wrap up. Pretty straightforward, actually. So sometimes you can look up these codes in your shipping or in your eBay history, but a lot of times when stuff has been waiting around for months and months, or just takes months to get here, those codes don't do anything anymore. And these ones that come from the drop shipping place in Mississauga, they don't have that code on them anyway. So let's put everything out of the way. Okay, let's grab something and just get into it, because that's what we're really here for, isn't it? This one says LED lights. So the point of all that is, a lot of times I honestly don't know what's in the package until I do that. This one is a bunch of clear LEDs. They could be anything, because like I said, I ordered these, you know, up to 6 months ago in some cases, but it's pretty easy to figure it out. These are blue. Oh wait, these aren't normal blue. These are the kind of pseudo ultraviolet blacklight type blue, I think. You may recall some months ago when I built this LED kit, and I used that same type of LEDs in it, the pseudo ultraviolet ones. So it look like the same color to your eyes? It's a little bit different, but I think that's what those are. I will go and look them up now on the computer and see if we can find these. So it's just a matter of going scrolling back until I find them. And that looks like them there, doesn't it? I think so. Looks like I ordered them on May 28th, so I'll add that to my little note and we'll carry on. F5, 5mm round ultraviolet LED UV light, 365 nanometer, 390 nanometer, 395 nanometer, 405 nanometer purple lamp. I got this from Deal LED, but they are no longer selling anything, so I can't get any more information from them. As you saw earlier, I paid $3.97 Canadian for these with no shipping. After doing that, the only thing left is to just make some notes into a little text document, which I will use later when I upload this to create the links in the description below. All right, and back over here. This one is another one that came from the drop shipper in Mississauga, so I have no idea what it is. There's not even any lies on the outside of it. A couple little boxes from Big Tree Tech. Ah, they are a company that makes a lot of 3D printer bits and pieces and accessories. This looks like a stepper motor driver. They got a link to their GitHub on that card. I'll hang on to that. So in the box, we have one little jumper wire. We have a heat sink with sticky pad on the back of it. And we have a stepper motor driver. It looks like it follows the same form factor as the ones that I've been using in my stepper motor project. I assume most of you remember this project that I'm working on. And I will get back to that in a few weeks. I'm just waiting for some more stuff and some more time to work on it. Anyway, these, if I remember correctly, are a little bit higher end than the ones that I've got. But I think they follow the same pinout. I'll have to check that before I drop one in, but I'm pretty sure that's the same. Big Tree Tech TMC 2208 version 3.0 stepper motor driver UART 4 SKR version 1.3 version 1.4 GTR MKS Gen, whatever that means. I got these from BQ, something like that. Right now they're selling for $1,140 US or $1,528 Canadian. Back when I bought them, back in, when was that? July. These cost me $1,360 for the pair of them. So you can get them in two different configurations, either step/direction, which is the one that I got, or UART, which takes a serial control in, which might be interesting to play with at some point too. They can micro step up to 1/256th of a step. Interesting. 3 or 5 volt logic voltage up to 36 volts for the motor. 2 amps all day long or 2 amps peak. That's pretty neat. Also interesting, the ones that I was previously using, the chip and everything was on the top. This one, the chip's on the bottom and has a bunch of vias up to this heat pad here where you stick the heat sink on. So that's slightly different. And it also had some pins facing upwards, which I'm going to have to look up on their GitHub and find out exactly what's going on there. Ooh, and these are the ultra-quiet ones. Oh, that might be interesting, too. But yeah, these ones are designed specifically for use with 3D printers. But they will work with any standard stepper motor, too. As long as you wire it out properly, of course.
Now, off to a pretty good start. Let's see, the next one is also something that came from that warehouse in Mississauga. So, we'll just see what this mystery is. Connectors. These look like ribbon cable connectors. Two different kinds by the looks of it. That one says 40 pin, that one says 26 pin. These are for ribbon cable. They're an insulation displacement connector. Basically, you drop your ribbon cable down across there, and then when you crimp the back part on, it shoves the individual conductors into there and makes an electrical contact, just pierces right through the insulation. So I've got 40 pin ones and the 26 pin version. The 26 pin version looks like it, yeah, that's the one that mates with the larger Raspberry Pis. Actually, most of them. I think the 40 pin is the one that mates with the newer Pi, or maybe it was for something else. I can't remember. When I was ordering these, I wasn't sure, so maybe I guessed and ordered two different kinds. So yeah, that plugs into there. This is a what is called a Pi cobbler. It basically is a breakout for the older style Raspberry Pis that allows you to break it out onto a breadboard. And we do have, I think, a Raspberry Pi version 2 or 3 around here. Belongs to my son, so I don't use it very often. And the last time I looked at it, it was connected to the TV just to use as a streaming box. But, yeah, let me see, where is that other Pi? Yeah, here it is, the Pi Zero that I got in a little box that I 3D printed. It mostly fits. And is that exactly the right number of pins? Yes, it is. Okay, I guessed right. Will that fit through the lid? No, it won't. Dagnabbit. Oh, well. I didn't design this. I just found it on Thingiverse. And I probably should reprint it a little bit better. But anyway, yeah, that will work on there. And that will get me the GPIO pins out to play with. Okay.
10 pieces, 6/8/10/12/20-50
pin IDC socket plug ribbon cable connector, 2.54 millimeter pitch. I got both the 26 pin and the 40 pin. I'll just look at the 26 pin right now. Actually, that is the same price that I paid for them, $3.69 for the 10 of them. And for the 40 pin, yeah, $4.67 Canadian. That's exactly what I paid in free shipping. This all came from Superior Buy 2014. There's not much more to say about them down below. So there's three parts to the connection. Okay. There is the bottom part with the insulation displacement pins. There is a sort of a crimping piece that goes over top that holds the cable in alignment. And then you fold the cable back and over top of the crimping bit. And you clamp the third piece down on top and it strain relieves it. Okay. Thing four. This one, the description is absolutely useless, even if it was telling the truth. It's all in Chinese characters. Again, no idea until I get in here. Two different things. Okay, this one is some kind of a circuit board. ESP12E and ESP12F, a little breakout board. Or ESP32 on that side. Okay, let me grab an ESP. So there is the ESP266-12. It is the board that's at the core of all of these various boards, including the D1 Mini as well. But this just takes a bare one and allows you to solder the little castellated pins there directly onto pads on the board, like that. And then it breaks them all out to this array of pin headers. So for example, TX data. Oh, just breaks out to that first pin. Okay. RX data is on that one. Okay, so it looks like it's just the first column of pins here. Yeah, the first column of pins goes straight into there. And then you've got all these other pins to build a circuit on. A freeform circuit to your liking by the looks of it. Well, that's cute. There's a special pinout for a relay over there. Huh, I guess that explains why that pin is in an odd orientation. Okay. And then on this side, we have an ESP32 broken out. Note that it has a lot more pins, but they again come all the way down to there. You can't use it with both. You use it for one or the other. I'm trying to remember if these were really expensive or really cheap. I have to assume that they were moderately expensive. Otherwise, I would have gotten two or three. I don't know. Let's go check. 5x7 or 7x9 centimeter prototype PCB breadboard for ESP8266, ESP12E, ESP12F, or ESP32 Wi-Fi relay. Came from CZB6721960. And I paid, at the time I bought it, $1.69 Canadian for it. There was no shipping at the time, certainly not a $37 shipping fee. What else is there to say about it? Not much. It's just exactly the same as the listing title. Okay, fine. We already figured out what this is anyway. So also in that same package, there's this little kit here. I see a bunch of LEDs in there. You got a package of LEDs, some capacitors, resistors, three transistors, and this little circuit board here. And it looks like a circle of LEDs around the outside. I'm going to guess that this is a kind of a chase light circuit using the three transistors and capacitors and resistors as timing networks to just sequence through the three transistors and, you know, probably, I can't follow the traces quickly without writing it down, but I'm going to guess that every third LED is controlled by one of the transistors, so that when transistor one is on, this one and this one and this one be on, and as the timing happens and it cycles to the next transistor, it'll step to the next one and the next one and just keep going around in circles. That's most likely what it is. We'll check the listing, and at some point in the future when I feel like building an easy kit, this will be one of the contenders. Circular electronic LED flash circuit light DIY kit, 12 pieces, production blue. Okay. Blue LEDs. So again, CZB672 1960. $1.62, which is what I paid for it. Of course, they've got the ridiculous shipping on right now because of international political tensions. That does look like the kit I got. Except for my LEDs have clear lenses, not blue tinted. It is DIY kit. User need to weld it. Components, we have 310Ks, 3470 ohm resistors. So the 10K will probably be the timing and the 470 will be the LED series resistors. Three transistors, two of one type and one of the other. I'm going to guess that a mix of NPN and PNP there. It's claiming red LEDs down here. Up top it said blue LEDs, whatever. And then the 347 microfarad capacitors, also for timing. Schematic is missing. Oh well, we'll figure it out when the time comes. And the third thing in that package is, looks like a little Arduino type board of some kind. Sort of like the LilyPad boards. So what do you have for pins around the outside here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 pins. And a USB for power. P012345 ground, V in, and 5 volts. It's got V in and 5 volts. It means there's a regulator on there. Yes, there is. It's right there. That's going to be an AT Tiny, isn't it? Yes, it is. It's a Tiny 85. Oh, we're familiar with those little guys. They might actually have sold this pretending it's a variant on a DigiSpark. Wonder if it's got the bootloader in it or not. I also wonder if it's got a Blink Sketch in it preloaded. Doesn't look like it. Just off camera, I tried plugging it into the computer to see if it's got the DigiSpark bootloader on it, because then it would show up eventually as a device, but it didn't. So this form factor is generally designed for doing costuming and stuff. You can stitch, conductive thread through these a few times and run the conductive thread out to LEDs or whatever on your costume and just have this guy run it however you want. Or not just LEDs, but also sensors, or if you're really brave and want servo motors on your costume, you could probably do this too. I think, yeah, the Tiny 85 is powerful enough to do a few servo motors. DigiSpark Kickstarter AT Tiny 85 Module 20SU/PU LilyPad IC Micro USB Dev Board. So they got a bunch of different versions in here. There's the normal one that you think of as a DigiSpark. But here is this little LilyPad module. Now, LilyPad is... whose branding is that? I think that's Adafruit's branding. This isn't obviously that. And I don't know what Adafruit thinks of these guys using that name, but it's just a generic AT Tiny 85 and a couple of support components. And yeah, I did pay $2.79, but as I said before, I didn't pay this exorbitant shipping. So there it is, and this is all just standard AT Tiny 85 stuff. 8K of in-system programming flash, 512 bytes of EEPROM, and 512 bytes of SRAM. It is 25 millimeters in diameter, aka 1 inch for that one country that still uses those. And yeah, it calls itself an AT Tiny 85 LilyPad. Wearable, there we go, for wearable projects. I stand corrected. LilyPad is actually a SparkFun product, not an Adafruit product. Although I think Adafruit does sell them and has some projects for them as well on their blog and their other pages. So I'm not seeing anything that looks exactly like the LilyPad, the knockoff LilyPad that I got here. So maybe they're just hijacking the name and the general shape. But you can see that this entire LilyPad ecosystem is designed around these little holes on the side here that you stitch into, and there's some LEDs. These are actually, I think, WS2812 LEDs. There's a push button. There's a little battery board by the looks of it. Yeah, it's an entire ecosystem for wearable electronics putting into your costume or whatever. Let's just take a look at this tiny one here that they sell. It does have an AT Tiny on it, but which one? Oh, it is an 80-tiny 85. But this one is 20 millimeters rather than 25, like the one that I've got, and it only has some of the GPIO broken out. Okay. But that's even more straightforward than the one that I've got. The one that I've got looks like they've just sort of gone halfway between the Digispark and this. I guess they're not going to get sued except for using the name. And the last thing in, also the largest thing, also the one that I know exactly what it is, because this came from Evil Mad Science LLC in the States. I mean, how can you not order something from a company called Evil Mad Science? This is a kit. This is a kit to build an enormous 555 timer out of discrete components. Does that sound like fun to you? That sounds like an amazing time to me. And folded into the invoice is a sticker, which I'll have to add to my wall that you can't see, that's just up there. And there's what I paid for it, $35 plus $12.25 shipping. So that, yeah, that is way more than I normally pay for stuff. But look at it! It's a giant 555! So you got a set of basic instructions. Okay, it's actually got all the details. It's got all the resistors there and the order, resistors, transistors, terminal posts. And then how to use it in our old favorite circuit, the 555. Very cool. Huge chip legs. Now, obviously, these aren't the actual legs that it uses to connect to the outside world. But it is a mount and it looks awesome. Oh, I gotta take a look at this board. That is a heavy, heavy circuit board. That board's a full 3 millimeters thick. Wow. That is solid. Okay, so those legs just mount on there like that. They've got clearance holes for these so that it doesn't short out. Clever. And it's even laid out into discrete sections here. So we have the threshold and comparator. We have a trigger comparator. We have a flip-flop, and we have an output, all made with discrete components, all laid out. You can see exactly what's going on. Ha ha ha, that is amazing. And then there's all the components. I don't think I've ever seen a kit that's got the resistors packaged that way before. Maybe, did the old Heathkit kits come like this? I'm not sure. But that is very cool. And then we've got all the transistors, and that's a lot of them too. So I'm guessing we've got half of these are NPNs and half of them are PNPs. So yeah, it is a combination of NPNs and PNPs. Okay. Which I guess that makes complete sense based on what's going on in there. So there's that threshold comparator, the trigger comparator, the flip-flop, and the output section. 13 NPN, 13 PNP. This is going to be a fine kit to build. I think I'm going to save this for when I've got a week off work so I can actually sit down and just savor it rather than blitzing through it in a hurry. Oh, hey, they also have a kit for the 741 op amp. Once my bank account recovers a little bit, I'm going to have to come back here and see what other fun things they have that I might want to play with. And there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. And quite the haul it is, too. Now, this is the part of the video where those notes that I was mentioning, that I was adding onto the post-it notes, this is where it comes in handy. These near-ultraviolet LEDs took 28 days to get here. The ribbon cable crimps took 17 days because, again, they came from the Canadian warehouse. The two stepper drivers took 11 days. Same story. These three things, the kit, the lily pad, and the ESP breakout board, that came from China. That took 111 days. I ordered it on March 11th. It showed up at the beginning of July, which is why when I opened it, I didn't really remember what I'd ordered, because that was, How many months ago was March? Yeah. Anyway, where was I? Oh, yeah. And the stepper motor drivers, yeah, they took 11 days. This guy, the 555, it took 19 days. Of course it did. I ordered it directly from the company in the States. So, yeah, there we go. A wide, wide variety. Comments and questions down below, as usual. Thanks, as always, to my Patreon supporters for helping me pay for this. I went a little bit above and beyond their generosity this time, but that's okay too, because this is going to be fun. Thanks to all of you for watching. I'd love to hear what you have to say about this. And as always, I will talk to you later.